We are here together. Due to pandemic situation, we are here together online for our standard 10th orientation program. I would like to welcome our inspirator and motivator towards the path of 100% result, Honorable Mr. Raju Tadvi sir, our Education Officer, Secondary Department, Honorable Mrs. Mamta Rao Madam, Deputy EO Secondary Department, Honorable Mr. Mukhtar Shah, our Superintendent, Honorable Mr. Vijay Jadhav sir, our AO, and our beat officer, Honorable Mr. Vishwas Rokhde sir. Along with them, I also welcome all the beat officer of all the mediums. And now I take privilege and honor for me to introduce our eminent guest speaker, Mr. Rakesh Verma sir. I am really pleased and honored to speak about him. He has been an inspiration to everyone because not only he is hardworking and dedicated toward his job, but also passionate about it. Rakesh Verma sir is working as supervisor in MD Bhartiya English Medium High School, Ghatkopar East since 25 years with an educational qualification BSc MABA. He has been moderator for algebra paper from last 8 years. Also, his effort and loyalty towards teaching made him achieve Guru Dharmacharya Award from the hand of Sri Kirit Somaya Ji, our former MP. So, student, now I won't take your much time because I know even you are waiting to listen to him and grab the opportunity towards the path of success. So, students, be ready with your book and pen. Now, I request Mr. Rakesh Verma sir to continue. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Sabha. Before we start the session, there are a few instructions for all the participants. Firstly, you may ask your questions and queries only at the end of the session by raising your hand. And secondly, the attendance link will be provided in the chat box at the end. So be present for the entire session as your attendance will be considered for the internal evaluation. So on this note, let us start with our today's session. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Good evening to one and all present for this online guidance lecture. First of all, I'd like to thank BMC Education Department, all dignitaries of BMC Education Department for giving me this opportunity to interact with all the students. Thank you, sir. Now, dear student, I'm Mr. Rakesh Verma. I'll be giving you a few guidance topics, some tips for your SSC board exam. Now, as madam said, if you have any doubt, any queries, please feel very free to interact with me at the end of the session. And I'll try to help you out. Now see, 10th standard, I think all of you are aware about it, that it is a very crucial year. In fact, I can say that your future is completely depend upon what percentage you get in your board exam, SSC board exam. So I'll just request every child present here who is hearing me, who are in the on the YouTube, who are watching on the YouTube channel, please take this exam very seriously, very seriously. Still, you have got enough of time so that you can prepare for your board exam. There's nothing wrong that, you know, there's nothing to feel guilt that you have not prepared up till now. Still, you have got enough of time. Still, if you make your timetable, definitely you can do it. And regarding algebra subject, maths, one subject, if I talk, generally, this is what observe that, you know, children, they find maths subject little difficult. They feel it is difficult. In reality, actually, it is not a difficult subject, but they have that fear of maths, especially for the maths. Let me tell you, children, maths is not a difficult subject. It is one of the very easy subjects because you don't have to mug up anything in the maths. It is a concept-based subject. If you understand the concept, if you practice the topic, you will never forget. You don't have to rectify anything. Getting my point? So what you're supposed to do, it requires regular practice. That's it. If you understand the concept, practice regularly, 101% you can score very good percentage. But yes, it cannot be learned in one day. So it requires regular practice. So make a timetable in such a way that every day you devote some time for maths, then only somewhere you will able to cope up with the subject. And remember, maths is a subject where you can score 40 on 40. If I talk about a maths one, algebra, even in geometry, you can score 40 on 40. There are children who are scoring 40 on 40. Matlab 100% marks they are scoring. Correct? So I cannot say it is a difficult subject. If it's a difficult subject, they could have not scored more than 30, 35. But in the board result, if you see, there are so many students scoring 39, 38, 40 marks. That's why I say it is not a difficult subject. But yes, it requires practice, regular practice. So do regular practice, understand the concept very carefully. Definitely you can do it. Okay. And you know, you are not, I should not say that you are only working for passing SSC. Please keep a goal in your mind that yes, I want to score more than 80%. I want to score more than 85%. Keep a goal. And then you prepare. I'm telling you, definitely you can reach to the goal. If you don't have the goal now for SSC exam, then you know you will be just your mind will be like distracting here and there. But if you have a goal, definitely you'll work for it. So keep a goal, and then you start practicing for that. Okay, I'll just share the screen, and I'll guide you how you're supposed to go about with your board exam. Ma'am, is my screen visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is a guidance.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Now, first of all, just talk about the complete structure of your exam pattern, especially for the maths. As all of you know, that written exam you're going to write for 80 marks. Out of that, 40 marks is for algebra, that is maths 1, and 40 marks is geometry, that is maths 2. Each paper will be for 2 hours. That I think everybody must be knowing. Apart from that theory paper, you have internal evaluation. Remember, 20 marks internal evaluation that school will be sending marks to the board. Out of the 20 marks, 10 marks is in algebra, 10 marks in geometry. Like that, 20 marks assignment will be sent by the school. Now the 10 marks internal, which is there if I talk about maths 1, that 10 mark you can score full 10 marks, 10 on 10 in maths you can score in algebra if I talk about. The 10 marks internal consists of assignment, home assignment, and it can be MCQ or it can be practical, depend upon your school. Okay. Now assignments are also very simple. It is a home assignment. It is not like an exam. Teachers will give you 5 assignment in every, the total 5 assignment you're supposed to write in algebra. Each assignment will have 5 questions. That is total 25 questions. Correct? That you can have each assignment for 10 marks. That 50 marks can be converted out of 5 marks. So that 5 mark will be assignment and 5 marks they can take for MCQ questions or maybe practicals. Total 10 marks. And remember, it is all home assignment. There is no exam for it. So very easily you can score full marks in algebra as well as in geometry. So make sure that at any cost, you should not lose a single marks from the internal. For that, you have to just submit the assignment neatly, properly, in time. That's all. If you can do that, everybody can get full marks. Okay? So that internal marks is in your hand. Correct? Now, so total marks become 100 marks if I talk about maths, completely maths. Okay? Fine. Now, let us come back to your paper pattern. Now, what type of paper you will be getting in the board exam and how you're supposed to study. I'll be giving you detail that what should be your time management? Because, you know, in the maths paper, you must have heard that many children saying that, "Arey, mera itna chhut gaya, you know, time kam pad gaya mujhe. I was not able to complete that last question. Correct? This is all happened because of the lack of time management. Somewhere if you can manage your time, na, I'm telling you, very easily you can score good marks. So I'll help you out how to manage your time, and that you can practice right from like practice paper, not directly in the board exam, but before that, when you write the practice paper, that time onward, you can practice it. I'll let you know how you're supposed to go about. Now, when I talk about this paper pattern, like question number one, A part, it has A part and B part. Question number one, A part is a MCQ question. You will be having four questions. All four, remember, question number one is compulsory question. There is no option given. You have to do each and every sub question in question number one. So if I talk about A part, which is an MCQ question, there will be four questions given to you. For each question, there will be four options given to you, A, B, C, D. You have to choose a correct option and you have to write the, in answer, you're supposed to write only the option number. You don't have to write the complete answer or you don't have to solve it. Like for example, when I say question number one, A part, my first question, say if I say answer is option number B. Okay. So you have to write only answer as option B. You may write correct option B. Maximum, if you want in the bracket, you can write that answer after B. But you don't have to solve it anything there. We don't want your solution there. We search for only what option you have written. If you have written correct option, you'll get full marks. So that you make a note of it. Because many children, you know, they solve the sum and they do not write the correct option. Remember, as per the board rule, you may get zero if you solve and if you do not write the correct answer. Correct option number if you don't write. Okay, so B, and it is always mentioned in the question paper also. On the question paper, it will be written, write option number only for question number 1A. So make a note of it. Okay, so four questions, you are just supposed to write every question ka option number, correct option number, A, B, C, D, whatever is the correct one. Okay, very neatly. Then come to the B part. Now, B part question may you will be having again one mark ka four question. One mark ka four question. Very simple questions. Okay, one mark question will be hardly, it will for two steps or maximum three steps, not more than that. So simple questions will be there. Okay, but remember, it is a compulsory question. So even if you write one question, sub question wrong, you will lose one mark. So be very careful. Now come to the question number 2A part. Now when I say question number 2A part, it consists of activity-based question. Activity-based question. When I say activity-based question, ka matlab, there will be boxes given. Like question number 2A, mein, you have to do two activities out of three. Correct? So you will be having every question mein boxes. There will be four boxes in every question. And that four boxes mein you are supposed to write the answer. You have to write the only correct answer in the boxes. It doesn't mean that only boxes you write. No, you are supposed to write the complete solution. Correct? And in wherever there is a box given in the question, you're supposed to write the correct answer and put a box around it. You have to highlight it. So every sub-question may four boxes, you're supposed to write the whole, so you're supposed to copy the whole solution as it is given in the paper. In the box, you have to write the correct answer. Four boxes may each box consist of half marks. If it is right, examiner will give you half mark. Now there are some children who have a doubt that, sir, there are some steps are missing in between. They give direct step. So without writing the missing step, we cannot reach to the next step. That is 100% true. You will be getting shortcut solution. It may not be complete solution. So you may have to write the middle statement. Either you write somewhere else or you write there only, you add a statement, you add the step, doesn't make any difference. But what we are concerned about, we are concerned about the steps which are given in the paper that should be written in the answer paper. In between the two step, if you increase one step, if you write the step, doesn't make any difference. But the step which are given in the paper should be written in your answer paper with the box, correct answer in the box. Okay, so you are free to add the step if you require. If you feel that without writing the step, I cannot reach to the step which they have asked in the paper, no problem. You add it. No issue nahi. Okay. Same thing you are going to do in the question number 3A part also, which is also an activity-based question. I'll come back to that. So here, question number 2A, may you're supposed to solve two activities out of three. Each activity is for 2 marks. As I told you, for 2 marks, you'll be getting 4 boxes. Each box carries 0.5 mark. Okay. Come to the B part. Solve the following sub questions. Now here, again, you will find easy question. You will be getting four. You are supposed to solve 4 questions out of 5. Each question carry 2 marks. Now in this question, of course, you need to solve. So questions will not be difficult. 2 marks bola to it will be not more than 4 steps or maximum to maximum 5 steps. Up. Marks you will be getting stepwise. Remember, so steps are important. If you write shortcut ways to get the answer, you may lose marks. You need to write all the required steps. Okay. So while solving, be careful. Write all the required step, necessary steps you write. Don't leave any step. So here again, as I said, each question will be for 2 marks. There are 5 questions. Go to the question number 3A. Again, as I said, activity-based question. Here you need to solve 1 activity question out of 2. So, aapko jo easy lag raha hai na, that you solve. Now, here you will have 6 boxes given. Each box carries 0.5 mark. Now, in question number 3A, activity-based question, there are more chances that you will get the question in which the middle steps are missing. There are more chances. So here, without writing that step, middle step, which is missing, you cannot reach to the next. So it is your choice. If you feel to write that step, which is missing, you write there. And then come to the next step, which is given in the paper, and fill the correct answer in the box. Okay, but don't forget to highlight your answer. Put a box around your correct answer. So examiner is not going to see your each and every step. He is bothered about only the boxes and the correct answer in that. If you write correct answer, you will get marks. If you write wrong answer, you'll get 0 for it. He will not see the middle step, what you have written, extra step, likha hai ki nahi likha hai, kuch aur kiya hai ki nahi, we are not concerned. Okay, boxes matlab it is like a fill in the blanks. So fill in the blanks mein apne sahi likh diya, you will get full marks. Okay, and try to avoid cancellation, overwriting, all the things you should avoid there. Okay, especially in the activity based question, man. Especially in the activity based question. Now, question number 3B part, you have to solve only 2 questions out of 4. See, option is double. 4 mein se khali 2 karna hai aapko. It's so simple to choose. Okay. Now here you will have each question is carries 3 marks. 3 mark ka ek question. Of course, step will be more. There will be at least 6 steps. Okay. So there will be 6 steps or maybe more than 6 steps also possible. Correct. So this question will be little bit in the elaborate form, or it will, you can say it is in the little bigger sum will be there. Okay, so you need to write 2 questions out of 4 in question number 3B part. Now, till here, question number 3B part. If you see, there are total 29 mark ka paper. Compulsory question I'm talking about. Compulsory question I'm talking about. So till question number 3B part, out of 40, it is 29 mark ka paper. And 29 mark ka paper will come only from your textbook compulsory, word to word. There will be no twisting of question. There will be no changing the number. There will be no manipulation of any questions. So remember, till question number 3B part, that is 29 mark ka paper, will be word to word from the textbook. Matlab, agar aapne textbook acche se revise kar liya, only textbook, very easily the child can score 29 marks out of 40. Very easily, because aapko kuch bhi twisted form mein nahi rahega. It is all straightforward. So if your textbook is thorough, 29 mark to kahi nahi gaya hai. Remember that. Okay. So it is, it is around 80% marks aapko mil gaya aaram se. So even a weaker child can score at least 29 marks very easily. कुछ नहीं करना उसको, खाली सिंपल सिंपल क्वेश्चंस रहेगा. क्वेश्चन नंबर 3B तक बहुत सिंपल क्वेश्चन रहेगा, स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड क्वेश्चंस. जिसने थोड़ा सा पढ़ाई किया रहेगा ना, द इजीली दैट क्वेश्चन द चाइल्ड कैन अटेम्प्ट. यू नो इट इज फॉर द चिल्ड्रन हु आर लाइक एवरेज और बिलो एवरेज, सच चिल्ड्रन ऑल्सो कैन स्कोर दैट 29 मार्क्स. Okay, now let us come back to the question number 4 and 5. अभी ये question में ना सभी लोगों को एक बड़ा सा question mark रखा. The children they come and ask, sir, question number 4 में क्या आएगा, question number 5 में क्या आएगा? कुछ नहीं आएगा. It will be very simple maths questions. As I told you, maths is a concept based topic. आपका concept clear है अगर आपका, तो वेरी इजिली यू कैन राइट. जिसने मगअप किया है, दे विल नॉट एबल टू राइट क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 और मे बी सम क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 में कुछ बाहर का ऐसा एक्स्ट्रॉर्डनरी नहीं दिया रहेगा आपको, ठीक है. इट विल बी समवेयर बेस्ड ऑन द टेक्स बुक ओनली. मे बी दे कैन चेंज द नंबर्स, maybe they can change the format of the question, maybe they can change the wording of the question, but it will be from the textbook only. Concept is based on the textbook only. Okay, so remember that. Aapko agar concept samajh mein aa gaya hai wo topic ka, agar aapko maths ka topic samajh mein aa gaya acche se pura, let them give you any statement, you will able to definitely do it, because formula remains same, concept remains same. Khali aapko, you have to just understand the meaning of question. Easily you will able to write the answer. But as I told you, yes, it require concept. Concept tabhi clear hoga jab aap practice karoge. So maths mein practice is very, very important. I have seen many children kya karte hain. They take the notes, maybe digest, maybe कोई का notes मिल गया उनको, and they just what they do, they sit and just they turn the pages. कि हाँ ये सम आ गया, देख लिया उसको, अरे हाँ ये तो आ गया, easy है. Then again they turn the page, again एक बार read कर लिया, अरे आता है समझ में आ गया ये. Remember, they may feel, they may think that हाँ उनको समझ में आ गया. वो timing के लिए रहता है, remember it is not for permanent. Until unless you solve it by your own. Doesn't make any difference if you do any mistake. Do it. Maths has to be learned by your mistake. Remember that. जब तक आप mistake नहीं करोगे, maths आपको नहीं आएगा. Remember that. Mistake has to be done in the maths, and that is possible only when you practice. एक बार आपने सम खुद से किया ना, उसमें mistake हुआ ना, and if you can rectify it, आपको हमेशा याद रहेगा, अरे ये सम में ना मैंने ये step गड़बड़ किया था. एंड ये स्टेप का ये सॉल्यूशन है, ये दिस इज अ करेक्ट वे, तो आपको कभी भूलेगा नहीं डियर चिल्ड्रन. So don't run away from solving the maths questions. आप अटेम्प्ट करो, ट्राई करो आप. रॉन्ग आएगा कोई इश्यू नहीं, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. फाइंड आउट द करेक्ट आंसर, रेक्टिफाई योर आंसर एंड गो अहेड. कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, उसमें क्या है? आपको कोई मकअप तो करना नहीं है, रेक्टिफाई तो करना नहीं है. खाली आपको स्टेप वन बाय वन स्टेप को लिंक करना है, दैट्स ऑल. व्हेन यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस मेथड ऑफ लर्निंग मैथ्स, ना, आई एम टेलिंग यू, यू विल नेवर रन अवे फ्रॉम द मैथ्स. ओके, सो एज आई वॉज टेलिंग क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर में आपको बाहर का क्वेश्चन ही रहेगा. ओनली द फॉर्मेट विल बी चेंज, नंबर्स दे मे चेंज, नेम दे मे चेंज, दैट्स ऑल. समटाइम अभी इसमें जैसे आपको टू क्वेश्चन करना आउट ऑफ थ्री, अभी आउट ऑफ थ्री में से दे मे गिव यू टू क्वेश्चन स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड क्वेश्चन का, आई मीन टेक्स्ट बुक का, विदाउट चेंजिंग एनीथिंग. इट इज पॉसिबल, करेक्ट? तो इसके लिए बोलता हूं, सबसे पहला यू प्रिपेयर योर टेक्स्ट बुक थरली. जिसने भी टेक्स्ट बुक किया है, दैट चाइल्ड कैन 100% अटेम्प्ट द होल पेपर. यू डोंट हैव टू रन अबाउट एन आउटसाइड क्वेश्चन. डोंट गो फॉर, यू नो, आई हैव सीन द चिल्ड्रेन, दे आर यू नो, बिफोर प्रिपेयरिंग यू नो द टेक्स्ट बुक, दे फर्स्ट आस्क द क्वेश्चन, सर what we should refer for question number 4 and 5, which book I should refer, outside question. Don't bother bachcha log outside question ke liye, there is nothing like outside question. Your main aim should be preparing your maths textbook thoroughly. Solve each and every sum, solve example also, problem set questions kuch se solve karo, dekho aa raha hai kya, that is more than sufficient. Don't run around outside question. एक बार आपका textbook complete हो गया ना preparation, then you start writing the papers. Maybe the past board papers, maybe you know your teachers if they give you any paper, maybe prelim paper, maybe from different school you can collect the paper. ठीक है? Try to solve as many as paper possible. You solve it. आपको अपने आप आपको experience मिल जाएगा कि what type of question may I am having difficulty, and then accordingly you can change the method of learning. Simple it is. Similarly, question number 5 may you are supposed to attempt only one question out of 3, out of 2, that is for 3 marks. Ek hi question attempt karna hai. Ha, here you may get question number 5 may one question may be challenging question. This is for the children who are, you know, above average. For them it is, those who like challenging question. Such children will get question number 5 may out of 2, maybe not both question, but at least one question will be from outside question. Outside matlab again concept aapko textbook ka hi rahega, but question will be completely different. The child who can understand the meaning of question, can relate with the concept, the child can do it. Okay, so iske liye bhi aapko practice lagega. Jisne bhi acche se practice kiya rahega, the child can easily correlate. Okay, but at least what I will say all of you, ki at least you can attempt the question number 4 and 5. Aapko jitna aata hai na, utna likho. If a child think that, or I'm not able to, you know, I'm a weak child in maths, okay, I'm not able to do all the question, theek hai bacha, no issue. Aap koshish karo, jitna jamta hai na utna likho. If you feel that do step mujhe aata hai, teen step aata hai iska, utna likho na, no issue. If you feel that mujhe formula aata hai, light formula at least, aapko jitna aata hai utna step you are supposed to attempt. Don't leave paper blank or any question blank question paper pe you will not get any marks, but if you have written some step correctly, you may get some marks, maybe half marks. That half marks is also very important. Question mein agar aapko half mark milta hai, that get rounded up, it become one, to aapko half mark bonus mil gaya na. Okay, so remember that. Fine, so this is actually your total 40 मार्क का कंपल्सरी पेपर एंड 60 मार्क्स का विथ ऑप्शन पेपर. मतलब एक्चुअली जो है ना पेपर, आपको 40 मार्क का पेपर नहीं लिखना चाहिए, यू आर सपोज टू प्रिपेयर फॉर 60 मार्क पेपर. मतलब यू शुड बी इन पोजिशन टू सॉल्व ऑल द क्वेश्चन इंक्लूडिंग ऑप्शन. ओके, दैट आई टॉक टू यू इन द अदर स्लाइड्स. ओके फाइन, सो दिस इज अ पेपर पैटर्न. 29 मार्क एज आई सेड टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. तो 29 मार्क तो सबको मिलना ही चाहिए विदाउट एनी डाउट. ओके, एंड अगर 29 मार्क्स के लिए आपने प्रिपेयर कर लिया, ऑटोमेटिकली यू आर प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 एंड 5th वन. ओके, सो ट्राई फॉर इट. नाउ वेटेज, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट योर अलजेब्रा में वेटेज इज फॉर द फर्स्ट, ऑफकोर्स इट इज अगेन व्हाट यू कॉल इज चेंजिंग. It is flexible. There is no fixed weightage. Not necessary the same weightage will be, you know, will be considered by the board. But approximately, you will get this weightage. First chapter, you will have 12 marks. Second chapter, you will have 12 marks. Arithmetic progression, third chapter, you will have for 8 marks. Financial planning and statistics chapter is deleted for this exam also. For this year also, okay, the complete chapter is deleted, financial and statistics complete chapter. So of course that weightage will be adjusted somewhere. So you may adjust that in the arithmetic progression as well as in the probability, because this AP and probability chapter is a complete chapter, pura chapter exam mein hai. So there are chances that it will be adjusted into these two chapters, whereas चैप्टर नंबर 1 एंड चैप्टर नंबर 2 में पूरा चैप्टर आपको एग्जाम में नहीं, यू मस्ट बी नोइंग द डिलीटेड पोर्शन, इट इज ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड बाय द बोर्ड आल्सो. ठीक है, सो दिस इज नॉट अ कंप्लीट चैप्टर, पूरा चैप्टर नहीं है क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 एंड 2, देयर आर सम टॉपिक्स डिलीटेड, करेक्ट. तो दैट चैप्टर अगेन, ऑफकोर्स दे आर लेंथी चैप्टर, बट सिंस द सम टॉपिक्स आर डिलीटेड, द चैप्टर बिकम अगेन वेरी स्मॉल, करेक्ट. सो एक्चुअली अगर आप नो इफ यू थिंक अगर आप इफ यू कैलकुलेट अराउंड पूरे टेक्स्ट बुक का अराउंड 50% पोर्शन इज डिलीटेड, अराउंड यू कैन इमेजिन ओनली यू आर लर्निंग 50% पोर्शन. सो यू हैव गॉट एडवांटेज दैट यू प्रिपेयर, एटलीस्ट यू कैन प्रिपेयर मिनिमम 2 times द होल टेक्स्ट बुक, इतना टाइम है आपके पास. Not only that, but you have got a golden opportunity to score very good marks because topic is very limited. Very less you are learning. You are not learning the whole textbook. You are learning only 50% of it if I remove the deleted part. So take advantage of it and try to score very good marks. And that you can do it. It's not very difficult. Okay? Fine. Let us come to the certain points which you're supposed to remember. Some points already I have discussed when I was talking to you about the paper pattern. As I was telling you, as I told you that question number 1, A part, where you're supposed to write the option number, like 1 ka option number B. So you can just write option B. At the most, if you want to be on the safer side, you can write in the bracket the correct answer, whatever answer they've given for B. बट नहीं लिखा तो भी चलेगा. वी आर कंसर्न ओनली विथ ऑप्शन नंबर ए बी सी डी में से करेक्ट ऑप्शन, दैट्स ऑल. बाकी वी डोंट रिक्वायर एनीथिंग एल्स. ओके, नाउ एज आई टोल्ड यू द एक्टिविटी बेस्ड क्वेश्चन, यू आर सपोज टू राइट द करेक्ट आंसर इन द बॉक्सेस, देन ओनली गेट मार्क्स. टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, 29 मार्क्स. ओके, एंड एवरीथिंग विल बी फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक एज आई टोल्ड यू. सो यू नीड टू प्रिपेयर द टेक्स्ट बुक very thoroughly. Now when I say textbook, matlab including solve example. Now see, as I told you, since portion is reduced a lot, there are chances that you will get solve example questions in the board paper. You can see that question, there are chances because content is very less, so they require sums to give you in the paper na. 60 mark ka paper unko banana hai, so content require, and since the content is reduced to 50%, there are chances that you will get a question from the solve example. So prepare solve example also. okay. Now, as I told you, question number 4 may, of course, it will not be completely outside question. We may change the numbers and some statement part that become, you know, you can say it is like a different type of question, but actually it is a textual question. Now, question number 5 may, of course, we say that it will be outside question, but again, it is based on the concept. So you may get the question from the textbook only wording may change. Or we possibilities hai na ki do question jo rehta hai na question number 5 mein. Do mein se they may give you one question from textbook, one question from outside. So still, agar aapne achche se textbook prepare kiya na, you have got the chance to appear that one question. Kyunki aapko ek hi karna out of two. Okay? This already we discussed. Now, let us understand some more very important part. Abhi kaise malum bachcha log, see, as I told you, you are not preparing for 40 marks paper. You are supposed to prepare for 60 marks paper. Matlab, aapka time management jo hai na, that should be for 60 marks paper. So when you are practicing the papers, na, make sure that you practice for 60 marks paper. Matlab, you should solve 2 hours mein, try to solve complete paper, including option. Matlab, agar aapko diya hai question mein se solve 2 out of 4. So try to solve all 4 questions. ठीक है, अभी आप अगर मान लो मुझे विथ ऑप्शन करना है तो मैं कहां करूंगा, मतलब पहला मैं कंपल्सरी सब कर लूं और लास्ट में पूरा सब एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन करूं, डोंट डू दैट. आपको ऐसा नहीं करना चाहिए. आपको क्या करना चाहिए, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 तो कंपल्सरी है, कांट हेल्प इट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 में व्हेन यू स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट पार्ट, आपको मान लो 2 करना एक्टिविटी, तीसरा एक्टिविटी एक्स्ट्रा दिए, आपने 2 एक्टिविटी कर लिया. ठीक है, अगर आपको लगता है कि अरे इसमें डाउट है, मुझे हो सकता है रॉन्ग हो जाए, लीव द स्पेस फॉर द थर्ड एक्टिविटी, डोंट सॉल्व एट द सेम टाइम. इनफ स्पेस छोड़ दो आप, गो टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 2B पार्ट. वहां पे भी आपको जितना क्वेश्चन कंपल्सरी करना है उतना पहले कर लो आप, जितना आपको आता है. जो एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन है उसके लिए जगह छोड़ दो आप, सफिशियंट स्पेस यू लीव. And then go to the next page for the next question. So, har ek question mein, at the end, you may leave some extra space for the extra questions. Complete your whole paper. Pehle pura paper khatam kar lo aap. Compulsory question jitna hai. Once you complete the paper, okay, come back to the blank spaces, wherever aapne chhod ke rakha hai. And then try to solve that question first. एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन जिसमें आपको डाउट है, जैसे मान लो मुझे क्वेश्चन नंबर 3B में डाउट है, अरे बी में मेरा हो सकता है ऊपर वाला इतना अच्छा नहीं है, कैंसिलेशन हुआ है थोड़ा सा, यू नो आई वाज कंफ्यूज, तो वो क्वेश्चन का एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन पहले करो आप. ऑलरेडी आपने ब्लैंक स्पेस छोड़ा हुआ है ना, डायरेक्टली गो टू दैट स्पेस एंड देन सॉल्व इट. ठीक है, सो विच एवर क्वेश्चन में यू हैव अ डाउट कि देयर मार्क्स कैन बी रिड्यूस, ठीक है, वो क्वेश्चन का एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन आप कंपल्सरी करो. एटलीस्ट पहले एक एक तो करो. जैसे 4 में से 2 करने बोला था आपने, 2 तो करके रखा है, 2 एक्स्ट्रा है, तो 2 एक्स्ट्रा में से 1 एक्स्ट्रा पहले करो, करेक्ट, एंड देन गो टू द अदर क्वेश्चन. दोनों एक्स्ट्रा करते मत बैठो उसका पहले. ट्राई टू सॉल्व एटलीस्ट 1 एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन इन एवरी सब क्वेश्चन. 1 एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन हो गया ना, देन अगेन कम बैक फॉर द सेकेंड वन. ऑलरेडी आपने स्पेस रखा है, you don't have to search anywhere, already space is there, you can just sit, you can just go through it and write the paper, write the answer. ठीक है, try to attempt as many as possible. आपसे जितना जमता उतना लिख, then you will say sir क्या हुआ अगर मैं नहीं लिख पाया, some space already मैंने छोड़ा है, ठीक है, और end में मुझे time नहीं मिला, no problem बच्चा, उसमें क्या है, just put a stroke there at the one stroke, simple, finish, no problem. Okay, now you may ask sir, why to unnecessarily solve the extra question, isse acha ki hum log paper revise kar lenge pura paper. Now I'll tell you one thing, sabse pehla reason, Now, when you revise your paper, मान लो आपने 40 mark compulsory question आपने solve किया. When you revise the paper, remember, it is a human tendency, human nature, human psychology that we cannot point out our own mistake from your own handwriting. देखो दूसरे का मिस्टेक easily I we can find it out. If I tell you to see your friend's paper and find out the mistake, ना फटाफट mistake निकालोगे. But that only if I tell you to find out your own mistake in your own paper, it will be difficult. You will not able to find it out. अगर find out भी करोगे ना, तो 10% mistake खाली आपको eliminate होगा, बाकी 90% remain as it is. There is no meaning. Correct? उससे अच्छा है कि if you solve one extra question, इन केस मान लो आपको 2 क्वेश्चन करना है, आपने 3 क्वेश्चन किया है और पहला जो 2 क्वेश्चन किया है ना, इफ सपोज बाय चांस ही इज अ मैथ्स, वी कैन नॉट यू नो अज्यूम दैट व्हाटएवर वी हैव रिटन इज 100% राइट. इवन वी टीचर आल्सो वी डू मिस्टेक, वी से समथिंग वी राइट समथिंग ऑन द बोर्ड, यू मस्ट हैव सीन दैट इट हैपेंस. ओके, इट हैपन मैथ्स में कितने बार ऐसा होता है कि हम लोग बोलते कुछ और है, लिखते कुछ और है बोर्ड पे, एंड देन वी रियलाइज आवर मिस्टेक. तो इट इज ऑलवेज पॉसिबल दैट व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग द सम, व्हेन यू आर सॉल्विंग इट, इट मे हैपन दैट देयर इज सम मिस्टेक और सम एरर रिमेन अननोइंगली, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू मे लूज मार्क्स. बट अगर आपने वही एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन वहां पे किया है एंड इफ इट इज करेक्ट, you will get full marks for that. Upper wala question where you got less mark, that will go for the extra question. That will be taken as extra. It is not that the last question is taken as extra. It is out of 3, agar aapko 2 karna hai, and if you have done all 3, out of that 3 questions, whichever question mein you have got maximum marks, that will be counted. Where you got minimum, that will be taken as extra. So you are on the safer side. गलती से, एंड रिमेंबर मैथ्स में मिस्टेक होता ही है. इवन अ गुड चाइल्ड हु हैज प्रैक्टिस अ लॉट, स्टिल द चाइल्ड कैन डू मिस्टेक. समटाइम इट हैपेंस दैट व्हेन यू रीड द क्वेश्चन, फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन यू कॉपी द नंबर रॉन्ग एंड देन यू सॉल्व इट, एंड यू मस्ट हैव एक्सपीरियंस दैट. समटाइम इट हैपेंस देयर इज अ मिस्टेक ऑफ प्लस एंड माइनस, बिकॉज ऑफ वन स्मॉल प्लस और माइनस मिस्टेक द होल सम गोज रॉन्ग, यू विल नॉट रियलाइज. You will realize at the end of the paper, जब बाहर निकलोगे examination hall में, that time you'll realize. That time will be too late. Okay, so you know it is always better that if you solve some extra question, it can compensate your wrong answer. जहाँ भी आपने wrong लिखा है ना, it will get compensated. So I'll suggest, अगर you know if you have that much practice, time management is perfect. Definitely you can write extra questions. Okay, but uske liye aapko pehle se practice karna padega. Remember, you cannot directly implement in the board exam. Before that, you are supposed to practice it. Ghar pe baith ke proper paper solve karna padega, extra papers. And that also with the time factor, ki haan mera kitna ho raha hai. Whether I am able to complete, I'll show you the time management. Aapko kitne time mein kitna question karna chahiye, what should be your speed. Accordingly, you try. 2-3-4 paper likhoge na, automatically you'll get used to of it. Okay? Now, see the calculation. Now, when I say 60 marks paper mujhe attempt karna hai, 60 mark ka paper mujhe karna hai in 2 hours. 2 hours ka matlab 120 minutes. So, 120 minutes mein, I need to complete 60 mark ka paper if I'm considering my extra question also. So, with that calculation, I will get 2 minutes per mark. 1 मार्क का क्वेश्चन मुझे करने की 2 मिनट लगना चाहिए. 2 मार्क का क्वेश्चन है तो 4 मिनट, 3 मार्क का क्वेश्चन है तो 6 मिनट. तो विद दिस स्पीड यू आर सपोज्ड टू कंटिन्यू. इन फैक्ट यू आर नॉट सपोज्ड टू टेक 2 मिनट, इट शुड बी लेस देन 2 मिनट. व्हाई आई टेल यू, बिकॉज़ आपको 120 मिनट पूरा कभी नहीं मिलता है बोर्ड में. रिमेंबर देयर विल बी सम टाइम यू विल वेस्ट इन मे बी टेकिंग सप्लीमेंट, करेक्ट, writing your seat number on that, maybe tying the supplement, maybe some other purposes, maybe for thinking also. तो एक्चुअली आपको 120 मिनट नहीं मिलेगा, एटलीस्ट आपका 5 से 10 मिनट तो मिनिमम यू हैव टू यूटिलाइज फॉर ऑल अदर एक्टिविटीज, ठीक है? तो समवेयर यू नीड टू सेव द टाइम ऑल्सो, अगर आपने 2 मिनट की स्पीड से आप जा रहे हो ना, तो समवेयर आपको कहीं ना कहीं यू नो यू हैव टू सेव द टाइम ऑल्सो, 2 मिनट से कम में करना पड़ेगा. लाइक इन द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ए पार्ट में देर आर 4 questions, अभी ईच क्वेश्चन 1 and mark का है, मतलब 2-2 मिनट्स में करना चाहिए, मतलब 4 sub questions के लिए 8 मिनट्स, बट वो 8 मिनट की जरूरत नहीं है. इफ यू आर प्रिपेयर ना दैट ऑल क्वेश्चन मैक्सिमम क्वेश्चन यू कैन गेट ओरली विदिन 10 to 20 seconds यू कैन राइट द आंसर्स, मतलब नॉट मोर देन 3 to 4 minutes यू शुड टेक फॉर दैट क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. तो देयर यू कैन सेव 3-4 minutes. अगेन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1B में इट इज सिंपल, 1 mark का क्वेश्चन, देयर ऑल्सो यू कैन सेव सम 2-3 minutes. दैट वे इफ यू स्टार्ट सेविंग एक्टिविटी बेस्ड क्वेश्चन यू कैन सेव टाइम बिकॉज ऑलरेडी सोल्यूशन दिया है आपको, खाली यू हैव टू राइट द रिलेटेड आंसर, दैट इज नॉट अगेन डिफिकल्ट. तो ये सब क्वेश्चन में ना यू कैन सेव सम टाइम, and that can happen easily when you practice the sums. Practice karoge na, aap jo paper likhne ka practice karoge na, automatically wo ho jata hai, you get used to of it. Okay, so okay, fine, that saving of time that you can manage with your when you write the paper, that I'll show you that management, time management kaise kaise karna hai in the next slide. But let me tell you some more point which you're supposed to remember. Achha, now there is a question from the children ki, sir, where we should write the rough work? There are some children who write rough work on the same page. Right hand side make margin banate hain. Sometimes very big margin, and there they do all the calculation with a pencil or sometimes with a pen. Correct? Every page pe they make the margin on the right hand side. It is not required. You know, in the beginning, when the new syllabus came, the syllabus that time in the meeting, we decided that they should solve on the right hand side that rough work so that you know examiner can cross check. Okay, but it is not compulsory. You know, we realize that when you write the on the right hand side, na, the practice, the solution, the calculation, it become very shabby. Sometime it get merged, your main answer and sometime your calculation get merged, some part of it. So I will suggest, don't do that. Okay, keep your paper very neat. Rather than that, what you can do is, you know, you can write that rough work somewhere on the right hand side. I mean, on last page. Last page is, say, page number 16. Last page of your supplement, main supplement. On the top, you can write rough work and do all your calculation there. Okay? Because anyhow, that calculation, nobody is going to bother about it. Nobody is going to check. Nobody is going to see that. So last one page you can devote completely for your rough work. Okay? Fine. Now, as I told you, question number 4 and 5, you're supposed to attempt it. Don't leave it blank. Don't get scared ki are mujhe nahi aata, main kya karu. At least you should try to attempt it. Even the child who's weak, na, who feel that are mujhe nahi aa raha. Once you have completed till question number 3, make sure that question of 4 and 5 you try. Write, as I said, 2 lines, 4 lines, 6 lines. Jitna aapko jamta utna likho aap. Thoda thoda bhi likhoge na har ek question mein. At least 2-3 lines bhi jitna aapko jamta if you write na, you may get half of mark if it is correct. So that matters. It get rounded up. So you somewhere you can get the benefit. Aap blank chodoge, you will not get any mark. No examiner will give you marks on the blank paper. Remember that. Okay? So try to attempt. Even for the weaker child I'm talking about. There is always, as I told you, you should write all the extra question also. Especially when, you know, the question where you have a graph. Jahan bhi graph wala question hai, agar aap graph is of course very easy. You should go with the graph, definitely graph question. But, you know, when we say graph is easy, at the same time, it is very difficult to score marks in the graph. And it is a time consuming. Remember that. Now, why I'm saying difficult to score marks, you know? because you know there are many chances, there are a lot of places where your marks can be reduced. Even a good child can lose marks in the graph, whether you say knowingly or unknowingly. But graph mein aise bahut sare, you know, key points are there, okay, where you can lose marks. So if I'll suggest, if the child is, you know, having capability of 40 on 40, to koshish karo ki aap graph question ke badle mein agar dusra question agar aapko aata hai, go with that question. Graph you can keep it in the extra part. Extra sum mein you can do it. There is no issue. Okay? But try to do one extra question, because graph mein agar marks nahi katta hai aapka, to somewhere you should compensate. Okay? So try this. Even same way in geometry construction. So they are one and same. There are many places where, you know, marks can be lose. Maybe you forget to write the scale. Maybe x-axis, y-axis, arrow mark is not done. Capital X and capital Y, you're supposed to write the name of the graph, that is line, horizontal and vertical line. The line should be exactly on the dark line on the graph paper. Upar niche rahega, that also can be one point where the examiner can cut your marks. There are so many places where marks can be reduced. Of course, it is applicable generally for 39, 40 mark people. Okay, but at the same time, a weaker child, agar usne thoda sa bhi kuch bhi banaya hai, relevant, the child can get marks. Matlab, it is easy for the weaker child to score marks in the graph, but at the same time, it is difficult for the top cases children to get full mark. So accordingly, you are supposed to have, you know, extra questions also. Okay. Now this is a time management. Now, when you start solving your papers, your practice paper at your home now, maybe say this month, once you prepare your revision part, and many of you must have done also revision part. So now you can start writing your papers. School mein prelim chalu hone wala rahega, that prelim papers you can write. Before prelim paper, try to solve extra paper. You may get the board paper last to last year ka. Or maybe, you know, now market mein bahut sara paper available hai, ya kisi aur ke through, or ask your teachers to give you papers. Jitna paper aap practice karoge, practice paper likhoge, that more benefit you will get. Okay? Achha, now when you write the practice paper at home, na, do not write like that only. Aisa nahi ki subah baitha aur aap tak pehle paper likh rahe paper. No, that is not the correct way. When you sit for writing the paper, make sure that you are sitting with that, you know, time limit. Start the stopwatch, which at whatever time you start writing the paper. Complete the paper within 2 hours, or check ki aap 2 ghante mein aapne how many questions you are able to complete. You can underline and then you can analyze yourself. Arey, maine to 80% paper kiya, maine 70% kiya. Matlab, there is a need of practice. See that, you know, by the mistake you can understand what you know, what improvement needed in you, and accordingly you can do that, you can rectify, you can improve upon it. I'll suggest, now when you start writing the board papers, maybe in month of January or maybe February also, okay, try to write the paper at this board timing, matlab say 11 to 1 maan lo aapka paper rehta hai board ka. So try to write paper from 11 to 1. Kabhi bhi koi bhi practice paper likhna hai aapko, any subject, I'm not talking about only maths, any subject, try, if possible rahega na aapko, you write at 11 to 1. I'll give you the reason for that. You know, reason kya malum hai 11 to 1 mein, ki when you write 11 to 1 paper, matlab you are training your brain to think. Correct? Think. During which time? 11 to 1. So kya hoga malum hai aapka? Aapka brain will get trained to think about the answer, to recall your answer between 11 to 1. I'll give you a simple example, you know. This is a human nature, human psychology hai ye pura. Just say, for example, manlo, you know, you have got a habit of sleeping. Say, for example, say from 3 to 5 you're sleeping at home in the afternoon. Maybe your mother is sleeping. ठीक है उनका sleeping time. तो 3 to 5 is a sleeping time. तो remember, एक दिन आप मम्मी को बोलो मम्मी आप ऐसे बैठे रहो 3 बजे मत सो. Then see what happens. जैसे मम्मी विल सिट बट एट एज सून एज 3 o'clock बजा ना धीरे धीरे 3, 5, 3, 10 तो क्या होगा ड्राउजीनेस चालू हो जाएगा एंड शी विल फील अनकंफर्टेबल शी विल फील स्लीपी अपने आप कितना भी उसको रोको आपको नींद लगेगा ही लगेगा. व्हाई बिकॉज यू हैव ट्रेन्ड योर ब्रेन टू स्लीप बिटवीन 3 to 5 तो ब्रेन विल अकॉर्डिंगली वर्क. जिसको बोलते हैं ना आदत है मेरा आदत मतलब क्या यू आर ट्रेनिंग द ब्रेन फॉर दैट एक्टिविटी. सिमिलरली यू हैव टू ट्रेन योर ब्रेन टू रिकॉल व्हाट यू हैव लर्न एट द टाइम ऑफ योर पेपर 11 to 1. तो अगर आप डेली या मे बी ऑल्टरनेट डेज ऑल्सो इफ यू सिट 11 to 1 टू राइट द पेपर या पेपर नहीं भी लिखना है आपको ना try to bahead the question answer, try to solve the maths. मतलब आपको 11 to 1 में आपको thinking वाला काम करना है, even though if you're not writing the paper. Don't watch TV, do not sleep between 11 to 2 or 11 to 1. ये time जो आपका रहेगा ना, very crucial. Remember, I should say 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock के बीच में. You should not train your brain to sleep or to watch TV or to any other unwanted work. Only train your brain to learn. Bahead karo, solve karo maths paper likho, kuch bhi karo related to the learning. Automatically your brain will be active in that time, remember, and that will help you out during the board exam. Jab aap paper likhne baithoge na board ka paper, your brain will help you to recall what you have learned. Take my word. This is a human psychology and it works. So try करो आप. आप brain को जैसा train करोगे accordingly it will work. If you train your brain for sleeping purpose, 101% आपको exam में भी वो time पे नींद जैसा आएगा. आपका mind बिल्कुल नहीं चलेगा. You're not able to recall. आप कुछ भी कर लो. ठीक है? So this is one way you're supposed to write the paper. This is a reason why you should write between 11 to 1. Now come to this time management. As I said, for 1 minute paper ke liye, you should not take more than 2 minutes. 1 mark question ke liye. So suppose question number 1A and B part I'm talking together. If it is an 8 mark ka question, 8 mark ka question. Okay? So per mark question, 2 minutes we have decided, it will take 16 minutes. Matlab, if you start your paper by 11 o'clock. Make sure that by 11:16 तक आपका question number 1 हो जाना चाहिए complete. I have written 11:16 पूरा. You can save your time your question 1 में. As I told you, it is just a simple MCQ type questions. खाली आपको एक-एक word लिखना है as an answer. तो try to save some time. Maybe you can try to finish by 11:12. 4-5 minutes at least you can save. आराम से save होता है. कोशिश करो आप. Practice करोगे तो हो जाता आराम से. It's not very big deal. Then if you start with the question number 2, मान लो 11:16 को आपने start किया, question number 2 A and B part together is for 12 marks, correct? 4 mark and then 8 marks, 4 mark is a activity, 8 mark is a question, so total 12 marks, so 12 marks, total time will be 24 minutes, so 11:16 से अगर आप start करते हो, it will get over by 11:40, correct? मतलब बाय 11:40 योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 शुड गेट ओवर एट एनी कॉस्ट. देन यू स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 एट 11:40. 9 मार्क का क्वेश्चन इट इज. 3 मार्क वन एक्टिविटी एंड 6 मार्क इज अ क्वेश्चन. टोटल 9 मार्क. दैट विल रिक्वायर 18 मिनट्स. तो 11:40 टू 11:58 मतलब 12 बजे के पहले बिफोर 12 o'clock तक आपका क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 100% हो जाना चाहिए. Then come to the question number 4. Question number 4 carries 8 mark. Time allotted will be 16 minutes. Okay. So it is from 11:58 if you start. By somewhere 11:14 you should able to complete that question number 4. Question number 5, 3 mark ka ekhi question karna hai. So that requires 6 minutes. So 12:14 to 12:20. Matlab by 12:20 your aim should be completing your entire 40 marks compulsory question by 12:20. करेक्ट, मतलब आपके पास अभी भी 40 मिनट बचता है. रिमेम्बर, आप बोलोगे सर हाउ इट इज पॉसिबल, हाउ कैन आई कंप्लीट पेपर इन 1 hour 20 minutes. ठीक है, यू कैन डू इट, पॉसिबल है. बहुत ज्यादा होगा चलो 10 मिनट एक्स्ट्रा पकड़ लो, 12:30 कंप्लीट, नो इश्यू. ठीक है, बट इफ यू प्रैक्टिस इट 100% यू कैन कंप्लीट बाय 12:20. यू नो इनफैक्ट यू कैन सेव टाइम इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 ए पार्ट में, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 ए पार्ट में. टाइम बचता है बच्चों लोग का, एंड दैट टाइम यू कैन डिवोट फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. मतलब योर एम शुड बी कंप्लीटिंग योर कंपल्सरी पेपर, 40 मार्क का पेपर बाय मैक्सिमम बाय 12:30. मैक्सिमम बाय 12:30 तक आपका ये वाइंड अप हो जाना चाहिए. एंड देन व्हाट यू विल डू विद लास्ट हाफ एन आवर में, यस, स्टार्ट राइटिंग द एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चंस एज मच एज यू कैन राइट. एज आई सेड, एवरी क्वेश्चन का पहला एक एक क्वेश्चन लिखो. इफ देयर आर टू एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन, दो मत करो, एक ही करो. दे गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, उसका एक क्वेश्चन करो. सबका अगर एक एक क्वेश्चन हो जाता है ना, देन अगेन यू कैन कम बैक इफ इन केस इफ द टाइम लेफ्ट आउट, देन सॉल्व द सेकंड एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन, नो प्रॉब्लम. बट मिनिमम 1 एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन यू शुड सॉल्व इन एवरी पेपर, एवरी क्वेश्चन. रिमेंबर दैट. अभी यू नो देयर आर सम चिल्ड्रन, दे से दैट सर एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन करूंगा मैं पूरा तो एग्जाम में मार्क कट कर देगा, यू नो दे विल गिव माइनस मार्क. दिस व्हाट आई हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम मेनी मेनी स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट स्कूल्स. This is a wrong concept, remember. Even if you do extra question, nobody is going to cut your marks. Remember that. Nobody can cut your marks. Examiner has to correct each and every question. Examiner has to give marks for each and every question, even if it is extra question. And as I told you, 3 question mein se 2 karna hai, and if you have done all 3, out of the 3, 2 question which where you have got maximum marks will be counted, and the third question where you have got minimum, that will be taken as extra. Maybe the third question is the first question only. Pehle question mein aapko kam mila, baki do mein zyada mila, that last 2 will be counted. Okay, so remember that. Don't be under impression that anybody is going to cut your marks. As a student, your aim is always to write in the paper. आप 2 घंटा आपको टाइम मिला है, यू आर सपोज टू राइट 2 hours एज मच एज यू कैन राइट रिलेटेड टू द क्वेश्चंस. डोंट थिंक एनीथिंग अबाउट करेक्शन पार्ट, व्हाट एग्जामिनर विल डू, व्हाट मॉडरेटर विल डू, नथिंग. नोबडी, सी एवरीबडी इज डोंट बॉदर अबाउट एनीबडी एल्स. You should write as a student. Your work is to write the paper as much as you can write. आप लिखो, that is your work. ठीक है? तो आप जितना लिखोगे, chances are that you may get more marks. Okay? So your aim should be completing your 40 mark paper by maximum by 12:30 maximum, and then half an hour में you can write as many as extra question possible. ठीक है, सो योर पेपर विल गेट ओवर बाय समवेयर बाय 1 PM. दिस इज रिगार्डिंग योर मैथ्स 1 क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो दिस शुड बी योर टाइम मैनेजमेंट. एंड दिस टाइम मैनेजमेंट ऑफ कोर्स इफ यू डायरेक्टली इंप्लीमेंट इन द बोर्ड एग्जाम, इट विल नॉट वर्क. इट हैज टू बी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम योर होम, मे बी इन द स्कूल व्हेन यू राइट प्रीलिम पेपर. जो भी पेपर आप ना, you will write with this time. Of course, starting when just 1 or 2 practice paper when you write, na, you will find that this time management is definitely will not be followed. आपको होगा ही नहीं. You will not able to complete the paper by 12:30. It will take more time. Some children they may take more than 2 hours also for completing 40 mark paper. But practice, जितना practice करोगे time management का, next paper लिखोगे, फिर next paper लिखोगे ना with the same time management. Slowly will improve. Okay, so don't get scared ki are mera pehle paper mein I have taken more than 2 hours, I should leave now. Nothing like that. It will happen in the first paper or maybe second paper, you may take more time. It is very much possible. doesn't make any difference, bacha. Remember, practice, write more papers, more dedicate, more practice karke, more prepare karke, practice kar paper. Definitely you can reach to that goal. Theek hai? Fine. Let us come back to the some places where, you know, generally marks are reduced. And, you know, I have come across the children who are having different questions, queries. Like graph questions, you have graphical representation. Sorry. You know, when you make the equation ka table, coordinate ka table, when you make, for every equation, see, as it is shown there, pehla write the equation, then write the table below that. Matlab, that table is for that equation. Sometimes we have observed that children, they draw the table coordinate, but usa konsa equation ka table hai, they don't write only. Don't do that. Pehla equation likho, below that write the table and the coordinate. Then again, second equation, uska table. Okay. Now table mein you can ask that how many coordinate we should take. Practically 3 coordinate is more than sufficient. Correct? But at the most, you can take 4 coordinates. Theek hai? Even 3 liya, toh it is nothing wrong. Nobody is going to cut your marks. 4 liya, toh bhi koi problem nahi. But don't take more than 4. There, I have seen some children, they take 5-6 coordinates. You are wasting time. You are wasting time, remember. Don't do that. Minimum 3, maximum 4. 3 liya, toh bhi chalega. Koi issue nahi. Theek hai? And then you're supposed to plot the point. Abhi, if you see now how to plot the point graph mein, very important. Sabse pehla scale on both the axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. That is important. Same scale will come for all. As you can see here, I have written x axis as a capital X, y axis with a capital Y. Correct? All the points are shown and the coordinates are written. Correct? Everywhere I have plotted the point and so coordinate likha bracket. Now, when you have drawn the line, I have written equation number, if you see, x plus y is equal to 4 at one end of the line, any one end, either upside or downside. Matlab, that indicate that this line is for this graph. So both the lines pe I have written the equation. Wherever you are comfortable, write any corner, upside of the line or downside of the line. Arrow mark, as you can see. So this is how your graph should appear. And then in case if they ask you solution, you're supposed to write the solution. Wherever you have drawn the table, just below that, write the solution, whatever is the solution of the equation. Okay, that is your answer part. So, ye sara kuch aapke graph mein hona chahiye. Okay. Now, in AP, if you talk about I have observed, okay, the questions like, you know, there are questions of consecutive terms. 3 consecutive, 4 consecutive, 5 consecutive. Okay. There are some children who take all the positive terms, even though it is given in the textbook. They take positive. I'm not saying it is wrong. It is 100% correct. Like, for example, if you take 3 consecutive terms as A plus D, A plus 2D, if I take the D as a difference. So A plus D, A plus 2D, all plus wala. I'm not saying it is wrong. 100% right. But when you solve the sum based on this 3 consecutive term, now using this consecutive term, your calculation sometimes become difficult and lengthy also. So that way you have to devote more time for one sum and maybe you may not reach to the correct answer also sometime. You'll do mistakes. So we always suggest the student that you, whenever they ask you consecutive term, always take negative and positive mixture. मतलब a बीच में लिया तो लेफ्ट हैंड साइड में a माइनस d a माइनस 2d राइट हैंड साइड में a प्लस d a प्लस 2d लाइक दैट यू कैन मेक द नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स 2 टर्म 3 टर्म 4 टर्म 5 टर्म एज मेनी एज यू वांट लाइक आई हैव टेकन 3 टर्म में आई हैव टेकन a माइनस d a प्लस d इफ द डिफरेंस इज d देयर आर सम चिल्ड्रन हु टेक 2d का डिफरेंस नो प्रॉब्लम सपोज इफ आई से 4 कंजुगेट टर्म सो इफ आई स्टार्ट विद a माइनस 3d देन प्लस 2d विल गिव यू a माइनस d Again, plus 2D will give me A plus D. Again, plus 2D will give me A plus 3D. Matlab 2D ka difference liya. Chalega, koi issue nahi. It should be equal difference. करेक्ट. यू मे टेक इन अदर वे ऑल्सो. फोर्थ टर्म बोला तो यू मे टेक ए माइनस टू डी ए माइनस डी ए ए प्लस डी, कोई इशू नहीं है, डी का डिफरेंस. फाइव कॉन्सिक्यूटिव टर्म बोला, यू मे राइट ए माइनस टू डी ए माइनस डी ए ए प्लस डी ए प्लस टू डी. नाउ हियर आई हैव टेकन द डिफरेंस एज डी. So there are varieties of answer, but I'll suggest always take negative and positive so that when you solve the sums, na, negative and positive, what happen, you know, it becomes easy for you to cancel, reduce. So you'll get smaller equation. Chota term milega, chota number milega. Calculation become easy for you. Okay, so this is just one hint as there are some question based on it. In probability, ha, what we have observed in the board paper also, na, ki maximum children, if the question come of at least two head or at the most wala question, at least or at most wala jo question rehta hai na, many children, they get confused. And what we have observed, what I have observed is, even not only the board paper, I'm talking about general practice also, in your school also, if you see, there are many children who get confused. Sir, at least matlab kya, at the most matlab kya. So remember the meaning of this two, very important. So when I say at least matlab minimum, minimum criteria. So when I say at least two head, matlab minimum two head. Do se jyada rahega, chalega. Correct? Minimum two head. Do se jyada rahega, chalega. This is a minimum criteria. Okay? But do se kam nahi hona chahiye. That is the meaning of at least. When I say at the most, matlab maximum, upper side we are talking about, maximum two head. Usse jyada I cannot take, usse kam rahega chalega, one head chalega. Okay, zero head chalega, but not more than two head. So remember the meaning of at least and at the most, because this type of question you will be getting. Okay. Of course, geometry construction mein that all you can write. Remember, this is a general instruction for all the students, especially during the board exam time. That is, you may say maybe after January or February onward, you should follow it. Abhi follow karoge, that is always very good. But definitely Feb onward to aapko follow karna hi hai. Especially you will stop eating all the junk food. Eat only healthy food. Because agar galti se bhi aap exam ke time mein bimar pad gaye, remember that time you have lot of pressure, stress rehta hai. And if your food is not good, remember the chances that children, I've seen, I don't know, you also must have come across certain student, ki board, you know, exam time, matlab exam ka fear itna rehta hai unko ki exam bola to, you know, they start vomiting, they have fever. Bahut sara problem aata. There are some children like that. Okay, maybe because of stress, maybe because of fear of the exam. And since it is a board exam, you will be getting the center, some other school, some new place. So ye changes hota hai, possible hai ye changes. So prepare yourself. It's nothing like if you take it as a normal exam. Just aap school mein exam likhne jaate ho, normal exam. It is like a normal exam. Only thing, you're going in some other school and writing the paper. Nothing wrong in that. Usme kya fark padta? Okay? So your food habit should be good. You should not eat junk food, remember. If somewhere it will help you out in remembering the things. Okay? So this you can start from now only. Now all that pani puri, bhel puri, all that whatever you eat, na, road ka, side ka, that you try to stop now. Okay? In case if you're eating now also. I have observed that many children, you know, exam bola to are na whole night I'll sit. Pure saal bhar nahi, you know, they will enjoy. But exam time mein, yes. Whole night they'll sit and study. Don't do that. Whatever is your routine, follow that routine. There are some children who are comfortable in daytime to study. Don't unnecessarily stretch in the night time. Take 7 to 8 hours complete sleep, especially during exam time, during board time. There are some children who are comfortable in night time to study. They like night time, you know, the calm atmosphere. No problem. But uska practice aapko abhi se karna padega. Aisa nahi ki exam ke din baith ke raat ko padhai kar rahe ho aur abhi pura raat bhar so rahe ho. Don't change your routine. Remember, as I told you, because you have trained your brain. अगर आपने ब्रेन को ट्रेन किया है रात को सोने का, आप डेली अभी भी सोते हो और एग्जाम टाइम पे बैठ के रात भर बैठ के पढ़ाई करोगे, रिमेम्बर डे टाइम में यू विल फील स्लीपी, योर माइंड विल नॉट वर्क. तो डोंट चेंज योर रूटीन. जो आपको रूटीन बनाना है ना अभी बना लो. आपको ऐसा लगता है कि नाउ आई वांट टू स्टडी, आई एम कंफर्टेबल इन नाइट टाइम, तो अभी से आप चालू करो वो हैबिट कि रात को मैं मे बी वट एवर टाइम टिल वट एवर टाइम यू वॉन्ट टू स्टडी यू स्टडी एंड सेम रूटीन यू फॉलो टिल द बोर्ड एग्जाम गेट ओवर. बट डोंट चेंज योर रूटीन. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि आपका जनवरी फरवरी तक एक रूटीन है और फिर सडनली मार्च एग्जाम टाइम में आपने पूरा रूटीन को बदल दिया. डोंट डू दैट. देयर आर मेनी चिल्ड्रन हु डज इट एंड पेरेंट्स आल्सो फोर्स. इट इज वेरी बैड. एग्जाम टाइम में यू आर सपोज टू फॉलो द सेम रूटीन. ऐसा नहीं कि एग्जाम आया मतलब अभी मैं रात को पूरी रात बैठ के पढ़ाई करूंगा. तो करना है आपको अभी से करना चालू करो. दैट रूटीन शुड बी फॉलोड फ्रॉम नाउ ओनली. ठीक है. एज आई टोल्ड यू पेपर राइटिंग शुड बी बिटवीन 10 to 2 PM ऑलवेज. ट्राई टू, अगर आपका स्कूल नहीं है या आपका जो भी है पॉसिबल है, अगर आपको इफ यू सिटिंग एट होम, मेक श्योर दैट 10 to 2 यू राइट द पेपर. ओके. एग्जाम दैट ऑल इंस्ट्रक्शन विल बी गिवन बाय योर टीचर आल्सो. एग्जाम हॉल में एटलीस्ट 30 मिनट यू शुड रीच बिफोर, मोर देन 30 मिनट आई शुड से, सो दैट यू कैन गो एंड रिलैक्स. बिकॉज बाई 10:30 दे विल टेक यू इनसाइड द क्लासरूम. तो एटलीस्ट उसके और 10 मिनट पहले आप जाओ, रिलैक्स हो जाओ ताकि आपका स्ट्रेस जो है वो कम हो जाए. ठीक है. हाँ, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. डू नॉट जम्बल द क्वेश्चन. यू आर सपोज टू राइट इन ऑर्डर. मतलब अगर आपने क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 लिखना चालू किया है तो 1 का ए पार्ट चालू किया तो बी पार्ट भी उसके बाद ही होना ही चाहिए वहां पे. ऐसा नहीं कि आपने बी पार्ट यू हैव डन आफ्टर क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. डोंट डू दैट. ओके. अगर आपने क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 चालू किया है तो ए पार्ट लिखा तो बी पार्ट उसके बाद होना ही चाहिए. नहीं आता है लीव द स्पेस, लेटर ऑन यू राइट. बट ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि बी पार्ट आपने फिर से कहीं समझकर क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 के बाद लिख दिया बीच में. डोंट डू दैट. डोंट जंबल द क्वेश्चन. इट शुड बी इन द ऑर्डर. हाँ, यू कैन स्टार्ट विद एनी क्वेश्चन. अगर आपको ऐसा लगता है क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 से आई एम नॉट कंफर्टेबल, आई वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 फर्स्ट, नो प्रॉब्लम. राइट क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 देन ए पार्ट. बट ए पार्ट लिखा तो बी पार्ट भी आपको वहीं लिखना है. ठीक है. क्वेश्चन का सब क्वेश्चन यू कैन नॉट जंबल. बी केयरफुल अबाउट दिस. ठीक है. बिकॉज एज पर बोर्ड रूल यू मे गेट 0 फॉर दैट क्वेश्चन. इट ऑल डिपेंड अपॉन द एग्जामिनर. ठीक है. सो डोंट डू दैट. नाउ समवॉट लाइक दिस योर बोर्ड पेपर विल बी देयर. द टीचर्स विल इंस्ट्रक्ट यू अबाउट टू राइट your seat numbers, your signature, your supervisor signature, center number and all that, subject, whatever subject paper you're writing. Paper mein, you will be writing like mass paper writing, write mass 1, mass 2, science if you're writing, science 1, science 2, SS if you're writing, SS 1, SS 2, okay? Subject you can write there up, history, geography, whatever you want to write, okay? Date and all you know. Language of answer always will be English. For English medium, always, for every paper, it will be English. Whether writing English paper, Hindi paper, Marathi paper, any paper. Language of answer will be always English. Remember, for English medium. Okay? So, this is just instruction. Of course, your school teachers will also give you. This is what I was telling you, how to write here. Because this is a major mistake what I have observed with the children. And still, there are people in the, they are writing different way the answer. Question 1. A part, write the correct answer. Then B, second ka, option number say B is a correct, write the answer. Option number C, write the correct answer. And so on. This is how you're supposed to write. Okay. I hope I'm very clear. And rough work, of course, you can do on the last page, that is page number 16. Write rough page and do all your rough work. Okay. So that page will not be counted. Later on, if you want, you can put a stroke there. Simple. Okay. So this is all about your, maths paper. I think I have covered almost each and every point, but now it is up to you. In case if you have any difficulty, any queries, any question, please feel free to ask me. So ma'am, shall we take some questions if they have any doubt?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for your detailed explanation of almost all the units. Now, sir, students will start with the next session, that is question and answer session. So please raise your hand so we can unmute you. Thank you very much. Arshala ma'am, please unmute the students.
Yes, ma'am.
Zoya, ask your question. Students, you may raise your hand and you can ask your questions, please.
Miss, hello, miss.
हाँ
मिस, जब हम अपने लाइव स्ट्रीम यूट्यूब पर डाला ना, तब मैं यूट्यूब में गया तो अनअवेलेबल आ रहा और मेरा नेटवर्क स्लो है, तो उस वजह से मैं ज्यादा देर नहीं रह पाऊंगा। इसलिए मैंने लाइव स्ट्रीम में जो कि यूट्यूब में देखा तो वो वीडियो अनअवेलेबल बता रहा।
हाँ, आपको मिल जाएगा वीडियो, डोंट वरी। और आपको पीपीटी भी ग्रुप में शेयर हो चुका है आपके टीचर्स के पास, तो यू कैन बाय द टाइम यू कैन गो थ्रू दैट पीपीटी। ओके
ओके मिस, थैंक यू मिस।
यस अर्चना बेटा।
यस मिस, जो आंसर पेपर है, आंसर पेपर पे वी हैव टू मेक बॉक्स और नॉट
इन एक्टिविटी।
Miss margin,
yes, you have to make box. I told you, you have to make box and write the answer inside.
In answer paper also?
Yes, answer paper only you have to make. Beta. Answer paper, mein you have to write the whole solution of question number 2A part, which is activity based question. You have to write the whole solution as it is given in the question paper. Jaisa question paper mein diya hai na, aapko waisa hi pura likhna hai.
Yes.
और जहां बॉक्स दिया है वहां पे आपको करेक्ट आंसर लिख के बॉक्स बनाना है उसके अराउंड।
ओके। यस फातिमा बेटा।
हेलो सर।
हाँ यस बेटा।
योर पीपीटी में क्या लिखना है?
क्वेश्चन होता है उसका खाली आंसर का बॉक्स लिखना है या पूरे क्वेश्चन के साथ करना है?
किसमें बेटा?
एक्टिविटी में जो
पूरा क्वेश्चन आपको मैंने बताया ना, पूरा क्वेश्चन जैसा क्वेश्चन पेपर में दिया है आपको वैसे ही लिखना है पूरा, ठीक है? और जहां बॉक्स है ना वहां बॉक्स के अंदर आपको करेक्ट आंसर लिख करके बॉक्स बनाना, मतलब बॉक्स के अंदर करेक्ट आंसर लिखना, बट स्टेप पूरा लिखना है जैसा दिया है वैसा का वैसा।
हेलो सर।
हाँ बोलिए।
हाँ सर, मैं सॉरी मैं शोएब की सिस्टम हो रही हूँ। एक्चुअली जो आपने मतलब एक्टिविटीज दिए, मतलब असाइनमेंट दिया है पूरा करने के लिए, तो जैसे 21 में सेट में है क्वेश्चन आंसर, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स, जो भी चीज है, मतलब सेम वैसे ही करना ऑल सब्जेक्ट का, हिस्ट्री का, साइंस का?
मैम आई थिंक आपको एक्टिविटीज जो दिया है ना असाइनमेंट वगैरह, वो शायद आपके स्कूल के टीचर्स ने दिया होगा।
ओके
ठीक है। अभी नाउ दैट असाइनमेंट इज फॉर द बोर्ड पर्पस टीचर ने दिया है या जस्ट फॉर द प्रैक्टिस दिया है?
एक्चुअली हिस्ट्री और साइंस का आया है जिसमें बोला गया।
मैडम मैडम मैडम, दिस इज अ मैथ्स वन गेस्ट लेक्चरर सीरीज, काइंडली आस्क दिस क्वेश्चंस टू योर स्कूल टीचर प्लीज।
ओके 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 टीचर, सॉरी टीचर, एक्चुअली मुझे कुछ मतलब इतना डिटेल नहीं मालूम था, इसके लिए मुझे लगा कि
Steph, ask your question.
Yes, Steph. Yes, ask your question.
So we have to write only answer or questions in answer paper?
No, you don't have to write the questions. Okay, only you have to write the solution. Question you don't have to write.
Sir, recently attendance link.
Yeah, attendance link is there in the chat box. Ask regarding only Math 1.
Sir, on MCQs, we don't want to write any questions, huh?
नहीं बच्चा, only answer you have to write. Question number 1, A part, first question, whatever is answer, option A, option B, option C, whatever it is.
Yes, जो है बेटा.
अच्छा.
Yes, Mayuri. Sir, in the paper, extra questions are compulsory.
No, not compulsory. It is not at all compulsory. Compulsory is only 40 mark ka paper. Extra question you should write for your, for the safer side. So that in case if you have done any mistake, that in extra question you can compensate that in case if it is right. Okay, but it is not compulsory. Compulsory is only 40 mark.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Yes, good evening, ma'am.
Sir, मैं दीक्षा बोल रही हूँ. Sir, क्या हम लोग financial planning और statistics ये दोनों पूरा reduce है? Complete reduce?
Yes, पूरा दोनों chapter completely reduce है. Completely.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Any more questions?
No, miss.
No, miss.
No, ma'am.
No, miss.
Sir, only statistics or financial planning is omitted, na?
Two chapter. That is chapter number statistics and chapter number 4. Okay, both the chapters are, that is financial planning. Both the chapters are completely omitted.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much for this one-to-one interaction with our students. Now I request Sabha ma'am to deliver a vote of thanks.
Thank you, ma'am. It's an honor to have been asked to offer a vote of thanks on the occasion of 10th lecture series by Brihan Municipal Corporation. I am thankful to Honorable Rajat Parvi sir, Mamta Ram ma'am, Mukhtar Shah sir, Rokre sir, Varsha ma'am, Rushali ma'am, and many known and unknown resources. On behalf of Brihan Municipal Corporation and the entire management group here, I express my hearty gratitude to the speaker, Mr. Rakesh Verma sir, for sharing their graceful words with us in today's session. I am thankful to all the participants for coming here and attending the meeting. We have been fortunate to have one of the renowned identity from academic. I am very thankful to the entire participants as well as sponsors to this meeting. I am sure that our students will continue to get significant provision from the diverse group in the future. I must remark a proficient sense of gratefulness to our guest, Mr. Rakesh Verma sir, for sharing with us some of the finest practices. All the participants of this meeting are all inspired by your highly sparkling words. It's not possible to thank everyone for such an appreciating involvement and the willingness they have expressed to finish the task. Once again, I would like to state that we are glad to Rakesh Verma sir here over the meeting. We thank you for being with us. Have a great day ahead. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am. It's my pleasure to interact with your student. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. Here I declare that today's session is over. So tomorrow we have a science 2 session exactly at 5 p.m. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone. Have a great time. Thank you.